All right, guys, I wasn't going to vlog this, but I am anyway. I finally got things going my way. Let me explain to you what's going on. I'm stretching one room here. And it was one of those things where two different teams of people worked together to screw over a restretch. Basically, the tack strips were installed too close to the wall. The carpet was installed. Then the baseboard guys come in and they lowered the baseboard right on top of the tack strip where you can't pull the carpet up. One wall was impossible, so I went to the other wall and I was able to get it pulled up finally. It wasn't quite as bad off. So I pulled it up and then I managed to dig the tack strip out from underneath of the baseboard. And so I installed a new tack strip and now it's something I can work with. We were gonna do the closet, but I think I'm gonna skip that now since I don't wanna mess with that. I have a kid that needs to go to bed shortly, but let me show you here. All right, this wall here was impossible. Now this one, it's basically the same all the way around, but you can see all the relief cuts they put in there where they tried to, you know, hammer it in and under or something. I don't know exactly what was going on with all of that, but basically I finally got this guy pulled off here. So I moved him back an ample amount, a little farther than usual, just to maybe make it go a little bit smoother. I cut the pad back and I wound up putting a little bit of that back. So now I'm gonna stretch this guy in place. And if it weren't for that happening, I would probably already be done right now with my tools loaded up and going home. It was technically, this was, you know, probably too small of a job to vlog, but I'm gonna go ahead and show a little bit of it anyway. Anyway, I'm gonna put my small stretchers in place and then move some of this stuff back and start power stretching it in. So I'll keep you in the know. All right, I'm making headway here. And the carpet itself is very elastic. So when you start stretching, you've got to try to find a place to stop. I guess I don't have any worry about pulling away from the wall on the other side whatsoever, but anyway, going decent. I'll finish this out and we'll take a look and see if there's anything else I can tighten up anywhere else, make it look better. Back at it here. Short vlog. All right, we're stretched in. I've got to tuck that in over there. Stretched in here, got to trim and tuck that in. Come in here, pull this guy up. That's what you get. So, if you're not interested, if you're not privy on what that means, that hurries me up. That'll make this faster. All right, damn it. I guess I'll fix something else before I fix what I was gonna fix. So, there we go. More fun. All right, I have put it back together with hot glue and tractored it back together, waiting for it to cool. And this one, instead of getting the power stretcher, is gonna get a knee kick. I'm just gonna kick the wrinkles out of it. I'm not gonna put any more on that seam, especially not being that I just got through adding glue to it here. So we're gonna make this one knee tight since it's the closet. So got the room tight, working that way. All right, I'll be back in a bit. All right, we're all back in place now. So this guy got the rip up and the new tack strip installed. And here, got the rip up and the knee over, and basically a seam got redone just about, and we're good. I'm not tight on this side of it, but we're also not tight right here in the doorway because I can't get the carpet up on this side. I would have loved to have stretched the entire room this direction. That would have been perfect, but couldn't do that. All right, guys, appreciate you watching the video. This is all I had today. I had a job this morning that the guy was somehow by sick or something, had to reschedule, moved it to Friday. So one carpet stretch all day long. This is my slow season, so you gotta enjoy this while it lasts, because it won't be long. The home sales market's already basically kicking off here. So it won't be long before I wish I had time to sit down. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. And if you need any questions answered, it's 512-350-1129. God bless.